Hey guys, and welcome to this tutorial. If you want to create geometric textures really easy in Illustrator or Affinity Designer, then this is the video for you. So here I am in Illustrator, and these are some geometric textures I have created earlier using the techniques I'm about to demonstrate. These geometric textures are great if you want to create graphic patterns and textures to use in your design projects. Now there are a few tips and tricks I'll be getting into to help you set something up like this. In this video, I'll not only be showing you how to set up your documents and create textures yourself, but I'll also be showcasing a really helpful design resource you can use later on in the video, so be sure to stick around for that. After this video, you will be able to create awesome geometric textures like this in Adobe Illustrator or Affinity Designer super easy. So, let's get into it. So when creating geometric textures like these, it's all about using grids. Using a grid in Illustrator and specifically snapping to the grid makes it really easy to move your visual elements around swiftly and build textures like these. So let's look at how we can do this. Now, if you're watching and have Affinity Designer, you can also follow along and use this technique. With your document set up, you can also snap to grid in Affinity like you can in Illustrator. So if you're using Affinity, you should be able to follow along just fine. So to begin, I'm going to set up a new document. I'll come up to File, New. Now on this occasion, I'm going to make a custom canvas size. So over on the right-hand side of my new document window, I'll change the units to pixels. And for width, I'll type in 800, and for height, I'll type in 1100. I'll explain shortly why I'm using this size. I'll set my orientation to portrait and click create, and up will pop my new document. Now before we start adding and making shapes, I want to set up the grid. To do this, I'll come up to preferences on Mac or edit on Windows, come down and click units. With the menu open, I'll be sure to set general to pixels. Then I'll click on guides and grids. For grid, I'll set the color to yellow, but you can set this to whatever color you like. I'll set the grid line to every 100 pixels and keep the subdivision set to 1 and click okay. And if you cannot see your grid, simply press the keyboard shortcut. To toggle on and off the grid, you can press either Command apostrophe on Mac or Control apostrophe on Windows. And now we can see a clear grid on the page. So I have set this up so there is a good few squares here to work with. Right now we have 8 horizontal and 11 vertical. However, if you want more or less, simply change the setting of the grids as I just demonstrated. But for now, I'll go with this setup. So with the grid set up, there is one last important step to take. Next, I'm going to come up to View, scroll down and select Snap to Grid, or alternatively, I can press the keyboard shortcut, which is Shift plus Command plus apostrophe on Mac, or Shift plus Control plus apostrophe on Windows. So now we have our grid set up and we are snapping to the grid, we can make a start on our texture. So for the first example, I'm going to start with something simple and do a circle texture as you see here. And I'm going to use this nice yellow and gray color palette I have prepared earlier. So I'll quickly select this and copy and paste into my new document, scale it down and place it under the canvas like so. So I'll begin by creating a background solid. So over in the menu, I'll click the shape tool, I'll grab a rectangle and click and drag like so. Now look how nice that is, snapping to the grid there perfectly. So I'll draw out a solid shape and make sure to fill it with a solid color. To do this, I'll make sure the foreground color is selected. I'll press I to activate the eyedropper and select my light gray color. In this instance, I have left a margin around the outside. Okay, now for our shapes. So again, over in the shapes panel, this time I'll grab the circle shape tool. I'll click and drag to snap a circle to approximately 4 squares in the center. I'll make sure the foreground color is selected. I'll press I to activate the eyedropper and select my yellow color. So with my circle, I'll press minus on the keyboard to activate the remove anchor point tool. Next, I'll simply click on the far right anchor point to remove it. I'll press A to activate the direct selection tool and click and drag the handles in to tidy up the edges there. So now we have the half circle shape. If I press V to activate the selection tool and click and drag around, we will now see it snap into the grid perfectly. So I'll click on my half circle shape, copy and paste, and drag back up to the top left. So I'll click back into the middle shape, and this time I'll press plus on the keyboard to activate the add anchor point tool, and I'll carefully add an anchor point in the middle, like so. Next, I'll press minus on the keyboard to activate the remove anchor point tool, and this time I'll click on the bottom anchor point to remove. Then I'll press A to activate the direct selection tool and drag the handles into the corner to tidy up the shape. So now I have a quarter circle and a half circle shape, I can start to make a pattern. But to make my pattern, I'm going to need a few more shapes. So to do this, I'm going to click on my quarter circle, press and hold Alt, and click and drag down and across. And as I do this, we can quickly duplicate the shape and it will snap to the grid. So I'll do this a few times to generate a few more shapes. And then I'll do the same for the bigger shape, duplicate that a few times, and now we have a bunch of shapes. And before I start making my texture, I'll just click on its shape, and if I move my mouse cursor towards the edge, it will change into the rotate icon. So I'll quickly click on a few shapes and just click and drag on the corners to rotate them into a few options. I'll do this with a quarter circle, and I'll do this with a larger half circle above, just moving them if I need the space. Next, I'll press A to activate the direct selection tool. I'll hold down Shift and select some of the quarter circles and some of the half circles to select multiple. With them selected, I'll press I to activate the eyedropper tool, and with the foreground color selected, I'll select the white color from my palette. Now I have some yellow and white options here, I can start to make my texture. So if I select a quarter circle, with it selected, if I just press up and down on the keyboard, look how the shape just moves through the grid so easily. This is all because we have snap to grid enabled, so as we move with the arrow key, it will snap into the next box. This makes it really easy to move our elements around through the grid, and this is going to make it really easy to move all our parts around quickly and easily to ensure they align perfectly. So I'll click on a few shapes and just start to move them up and into some initial positions. What I'm trying to do here is get a bit of contrast between some of the smaller shapes, larger shapes, some in white, some in yellow, and some variety on the rotations. I'll move them around, into place, and rotate again if I feel it's required, and also duplicate some shapes to fill up the space, until I have something that looks like this. If you're following along, have a go, like me, until you have a texture you're happy with. Once I have my initial composition set up, I'll press Command apostrophe on Mac, or Control apostrophe on Windows, to toggle off the grid so I can get a better look at the texture. So that's how easy it can be to quickly set up a grid, create some custom shapes, move them around, and make quick geometric textures like this. Now, something else you may want to consider here is increasing the scale of some of the shapes, again, to just add some variety. Here, I'll select one of the quarter circles and click and drag to scale it up and snap into the grid and remove and reposition any neighboring shapes. I'll duplicate the new larger shape and move it around to another place, again, removing and repositioning any neighboring shapes. And I'll do this again a few more times, and this will make the overall texture a little more dynamic. So that's how you can set up a document with a grid and work with a simple geometric shape to create a simple geometric texture. Repetition and simplicity can work well to create attractive looking textures. So next, let's try something a little more complex. This time, I'm going to create a texture that includes more dynamic shapes. So back into our document, now we have our artboard set up. A really easy way to duplicate this is to click the artboard tool on the left. Click on our artboard, press and hold Alt, drag to the right, and make sure to snap the artboard against the grid, and release. This will make a quick duplicate of that artboard and its contents. Next, I'll click the selection tool, drag over the entire canvas, and just remove anything so we have a new blank canvas. So we just saw how I created one shape, but to create a more complex texture, we are going to need lots more, which can of course take a long time. So for this example, I want to use my geometric texture kit. Here is a library that contains lots of unique geometric shapes I have created previously. Here we have some simple shapes, some two shapes, four shapes, stroke shapes, and pattern examples to choose from. So here I can simply come in and grab a vector shape from this kit here. Let's start with something simple, and I'll go with the stripes here. I'll copy, and back into my document, I'll press Command plus apostrophe on Mac, or Control plus apostrophe on Windows to toggle back the grid. I'll paste it, and right now we can see it's way too big. But that's okay, here I can simply click and drag on the corners and scale it down easily, and because Snap to Grid is on, it scales perfectly. And I'll scale it down so it's contained in four squares in the grid. So right now we have a background square and a shape, so this is going to make it really easy to color this in later, but for now, I'll continue to build my texture. So back into the pack, I'll select another shape. This time I'll go for the half square shape, I'll copy it, back into my document, I'll paste and scale it down. Now with the shape in place, it's super easy to rotate. I'll just press R on the keyboard to activate the rotation tool and drag to rotate, and it will snap inside the grid. Easy. So back into my kit, I'll select the triangle, copy, back into my document, I'll paste, scale it down, and rotate. And now I have the top row sorted. Now a trick to making nice geometric textures is not to use too many shapes. Loads of shapes will make it really busy, so I always try to keep it to a minimum. Remember, repetition and simplicity works really well. So now I have some shapes I can quickly duplicate. So I'll grab the arrow shape, press and hold Alt and drag it down and rotate so that it is variation. Back into the texture kit, this time I'll grab the circle, I'll select it, copy, back into my document, I'll paste and scale it down. One last time, back into the texture kit, this time I'll grab the arrow pointing up, I'll select it, copy, back into my document, I'll paste and scale it down, and that's the next row sorted. So that's all the shapes I'm going to use for this texture. All that's left to do now is duplicate and position. So now I'll simply click on some of the shapes, duplicate them below and rotate until I have 5 rows complete. So right now the texture is sitting right at the bottom of the artboard and I want an equal margin around this. So I'll click on the artboard tool and simply drag this down one square to fit it nicely. So now I have my new texture in a good place, though currently I have my default colors applied. However, this is now really easy to change. So I'll jump into my color palette sample document, grab a color palette. This time I'll go for a 4 color palette, copy and paste into my new doc and pop it under the new texture. With the direct selection tool, I'll click a shape, then hold shift and click on some other shapes to select multiple. I'll click on the foreground color, I'll press I on the keyboard to activate the eyedropper tool and come and select a color for my palette. Easy. Again, with the direct selection tool, I'll click while holding shift to select multiple, press I to activate the eyedropper tool and select another color for my palette. I'll do this once more for the last shapes and boom, I have a cool looking texture there. So with my texture set up, I can either save this as a JPEG, copy and paste it into Photoshop, or use it in another Illustrator document as an asset. I like to develop my textures in a separate document like this, where I can focus on the composition of the texture. So on this occasion, I did 3x5 shapes. Now if I click on the artboard tool and click and drag while pressing Alt, I can easily duplicate the artboard. With the selection tool, I'll select everything and drag it up and in, and this will scale the texture down to give me more space to add more shapes. Here I can either duplicate the shapes I already have in the texture or jump into the kit and select some more, making sure to recolor them until I have a more complex texture. Though on this occasion, I'll select all the shapes and duplicate them across to replicate the texture. Then I'll select all again and duplicate them below. I'll press Command apostrophe on Mac or Control apostrophe on Windows to toggle off the grid view. And now I can see I have an even more complex texture. And if I zoom out, I can see my 3 geometric texture examples. So this is how easy it can be to create geometric textures in Illustrator or Affinity Designer. However, it can be time consuming to create all those shapes. So if you want to get the geometric texture kit, you can get access. In a previous video, I talk a little more in depth about the kit. So if you want to use this kit, simply click the link in the description and it will take you to the geometric texture kit video. As you have seen in this video, the texture kit will make it so easy for you to create your own textures like this effortlessly. So when creating this type of artwork, it's all about using grids. Using a grid will allow us to easily work with shapes by snapping. When creating artwork like this in Illustrator, be sure to consider using grids as it can make the whole process so much easier. Now, if you're using Affinity Designer, you can also use this technique. Now, I believe some of the setup instructions may be a little different, but you can still snap to grid in Affinity like you can in Illustrator. Well, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, hit the bell button and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified of more design tutorial videos like this in future. Now, this tutorial was created for all my members of the GDS Design School community. If you'd like to join the GDS Design School community, where we chat about design, give each other feedback, and where I set design challenges, you are all welcome to join for free. Again, link is in the description, and I look forward to seeing you there. So until my next design tutorial, unleash your creativity, and I'll see you next time.